Welcome, welcome to another edition of Jazz Grooves on the Wave 94.5 and 93.7 FM and on DBS TV channel 35. We'll be talking to our friends at CDF. They'll be passing through again today and we'll, chit-chat about the, what's going on for the artist market that'll be happening up in the north of the island, between two malls, exactly. So we'll be talking about the setup for that and preparations for that as well. So all that coming up in the program this afternoon right here on the Wave 94.5 and 93.7 FM and on DBS TV. I gotta remind you, the opening of Jazz is set for the 29th, all right? That's happening at the Mindu Philip Park. You know that? 8 p.m. sharp. Headliner Movado will be there. Also, they have a Lyrical from TNT will be there. So it's also Loving Day will be there. Old School Loving Day will be there from Jamaica. So 12 acts will be on stage and some of the best from St. Lucia will be there. Mysterio will be there. Shemi J will be there. Sidela and Wildfire on stage. Also Afani's Evolution Band plus more. It's going to cost you $60 if you want to enter the Mindu Philip Park on the 29th, but it's set to be an awesome opening for the 25th edition of the St. Lucia Jazz and Arts Festival. So welcome to Jazz Grooves. This is where it's happening, the 411. You know us, the way we're the longest running media sponsor for the St. Lucia Jazz and Arts Festival. So we know our vibes. We have the vibes on lock. You dig? Jazz Grooves compliments my friends at Bank of St. Lucia, all the bank you need. Friends from Digicel, Be Extraordinary, Sea Island Cotton Shop and Board, Heineken, and my friends at Capital Financial. So we're going to vibes inside of, this hour. So just stay here and vibes with us on Jazz Grooves. Grooves on the Wave 94.5 and 93.7 FM and channel 35 DBS TV. What a collabo. This is a sweet collabo, you know what I mean? Longest running media sponsor, the Wave Gold sponsor, DBS TV. We're nice. Things real nice and tight, right, JR? Real nice and tight. Good stuff. So joining the vibes here this afternoon inside of Jazz Grooves. We have from CDF, Development and Marketing Senior Officer Jimmy Clavier is here. We also have the Events and Production Officer Nos Divad Enitie. What a name there, boy. Woo, good. welcome, my brothers. Good to see you guys. Good to have you, in studio here with me. We're talking about the artist market, and that's happening between the two malls in the north of the island. Let's kick off with you, Jimmy. Tell me about how we got to this point. Choosing the artist, for instance, that you're gonna showcase for this artist market.
All right. Well,
what was the process?
The artist market is an element or component that formed part of our National Arts Festival. We started in 2013 when we rebranded the National Arts Festival to call it now Artreach. We went into the communities and we had an element of exhibition where we invited all of the various artists from around the place to participate in this exhibition. And at the end of the day, what we saw was the amount of excellent work that our locals were producing, we felt it necessary to provide them with another stage that will you know, they could now basically, you know, make their work available, not just for display, but for actual selling of their work. To create contact with the general public and then sell it. So it was basically an invitation to all local artisans to come out and sell their wares.
How many artisans we talking here at this will be showcasing the arts at this artist market?
Well, the artist market is normally open up to about anywhere between 30 to 40 local artisans, and it's a matter of who has work ready and who is willing to come out on those particular days where we have the artist market to put their wares up for sale.
Is it the cost to them to having the booths and stuff like that to showcase this stuff?
Well, this is where Nozibad comes in.
That's his section. That's his section. Let's talk about the setup.
Let me add to what Jimmy said. It's actually open for all artisans, but normally they don't pay. Actually, it's an open invitation, but we have a list amount. So we take, if it's 30, we take that 30.
Okay.
And they present their stuff, and including fashion, crafts, they have a lot of art pieces, a lot of stuff.
Different variety.
Yeah, variety. So it's a whole variety.
All right.
But adding to that, we have a component, an entertainment component that goes through that day. You understand the day in particular? We have masquerade, then we have the dance, we have games, like traditional games that'll be happening. And at the end of the, from 10 to 6, and from 7 to 9, almost to 10, there's an entertainment aspect that's from the mall. Then we have on Thursday, there's where Bo Hingson is performing.
Okay.
And for 2 hours. And then on the Friday, where Baywalk is taking, and then we have Rob Zaitiller.
That's what your name did to me.
Yeah, that's
same
true.
Thing your name did.
And then we have Skip Monday, the band, that we perform on Friday. But Saturday is a little lenient, that we're just doing the crafts only and little traditional stuff, just to because we have main stage. So we're just keeping it simple. Thursday, Friday, full throttle. You can come, have a look, and get entertained. And Friday, likewise, until the night. And then Saturday, is just crafts and stuff and a little entertainment, traditional stuff.
Yeah, we must accommodate or allow for the actual main stage jazz, which is happening on Saturday. Yeah.
Right.
So you know, they
don't want to tie up.
We don't
want to
tie up.
For that reason, we finish off a little earlier. Yeah.
Okay.
What I want to stress on is that the artist market that we're presenting is 3 days long.
Okay.
In the past,
it's from what days? From the 5th, right?
It's from the 5th of May.
The
5th of May to the 7th of May. In the past, we've only had the artist market for one day, and probably just for a couple hours, 3-4 hours. Now we're having this running for an entire day.
It's like 10 to 10.
Exactly. So it basically allows for, those persons who are not able to come there around lunchtime. If you can't come there around that time and you could only come around for the entertainment, at least on one day, and the next day you still have the opportunity to actually still see the work that is out there and make contact with the artisans. And if you're not interested, if you're not getting something right there, and then at least you have the contact information for those persons so that you could get something from them later on.
We spoke about variety. They'll be showcasing variety, but go through some of the things we can expect, not just t-shirts and colorful little crafts and stuff. It's much more than that, isn't it?
Yes, and actually we have I feel the name itself is the real Nicholas. She does the necklaces, the jewelry aspect. We have the wire bending, Mr. Herman is doing that too. We have some designers. We have some, the 1-2 designers going to be here too. We have pots and clay pots going to be on display. That's somebody.
I want to clarify what we mean by clay pots. Yeah.
It's not
the normal clay pots that you find at the Castries market.
Very designed.
Oh, okay.
It is actually ceramic pieces.
So
beautiful ceramic pieces. We've got some ladies who produce those things in the southern part of the island, and they are very lovely pieces. She makes cups, she makes vases, she makes basic display pieces, very, very lovely work. Makes lamps as well.
Okay.
Great work. you know. So that's what we mean by that.
Yeah. Okay, so clip on. Not just the normal clip on. All right, you have to clear that. That's important to you, Jimmy. All right, that's good.
But I just want to stress on the quality of the work that our locals are producing. It is. I mean, when we say clay pots, we only think of one thing.
When we define it
and we say ceramics, now you get a different picture.
A broader perspective of what you're trying to see. All right, that makes sense. That makes a lot of sense. The setup. Where exactly we gonna set up for this artist market?
You're thinking between the two malls. Well, we're blocking off from the entrance to JQ Mall, and at the before Harbour, I feel the
Harbour Inn.
Harbour Inn. Okay. Yes. From that point, there will be a stage setup. There will be about 12 tents.
All right.
Along that side. Yes.
All right.
And there'll be in the middle of everything going to be the masquerade, the dance piece, everything going to be happening. Yes. And the entertainment will be on the stage. We are lighting, everything going to be happening on the stage later in the evening. So you understand? So that's how it's going to be set up. And plus we have a bookstore, I feel, the yard.
Okay, the yard.
Set up a nice little tent for this, so you can get your books sitting along. Real atmospheric kind of thing. You come there, you read a book, whatever. But it's going to be set up there, so that's an additional to the artist market too.
Yeah, because they do sell lots of little things
Yes. Yeah. Definitely.
There. Now you know this artist market is happening in the mecca of tourists. You know,
yes.
It's where it's happening in St. Lucia. A tourist visiting, you know, someone visiting and seeing all the excitement going in Rodney Bay. I want to know what's going on. Will there be some kind of an information desk, something like that going on? How could they get information as to really what's going on in the area?
The artist market forms part of the overall St. Lucia Jazz and Arts Festival. Of course, there is going to be some element of information online for that. On the day itself, all of the elements have been put together. This is a collaboration between the St. Lucia Tourist Board, the two malls, JQ Mall, Rodney Bay, and the Baywalk Mall, and the Cultural Development Foundation. So we're putting all of those elements in there. Of course, if somebody is coming up, and we definitely we'll be having offices on the ground, we will most probably be
decked out in your nice shirts. Zoom on the logo, you know. Everything nice.
it will be easy to identify the persons who are coordinating the event, it's not necessarily going to be somebody who's sitting at a desk, but persons who you could easily identify who you could ask specific questions about what is going on. We'll be able to provide you with guidance in terms of what is being sold, where it is being sold, or what is available for purchase. We definitely will be having information sheets that, you know, we could pass on to persons to inform them, you know, in terms of the programming for the particular period. So, you know, you will have the programming for the Thursday, you have programming for the Friday, and you have the programming for the Saturday. So you get a clear understanding as to what is going to be happening, when it's going to be happening. So if you are just passing through, but you want to come back and, you know, you don't want to miss out on certain things, that you have an idea as to what it is that's happening. Of course, we're inviting all the locals to come out, participate in this. This is part of our St. Lucia Jazz and Arts Festival.
It is.
As indicated, it is local artists presenting their work. It's not just for the visitors, it's also for us to link and make contact with our local artisans. So we, of course, inviting you to come out. You will be able to get information on our website on the programming for those 3 days, and the website is www.cdfstlucia.org. That is cdfstlucia.org. We will have, as part of our calendar of events, what is happening, where it is happening. So you could always check us out there, or visit the St. Lucia Jazz and Arts Festival website. They will be able to give you some more information on what is happening in terms of times, venue, you know, that kind of stuff.
Yeah. All right. The two good-looking faces you've seen here. This is Jimmy Clavier, and this is Nos Divad Initier. Yes, big name. Yes. And they represent CDF. We're talking about the artist market. It's happening from the 5th to the 7th of May, and it's all part of the St. Lucia Jazz and Arts Festival 25th edition. We have more chat coming up. Stay here with us on Jazz Grooves. Jazz Grooves, of course, compliments my friends at Bank of St. Lucia. All the bank you need. Right. Digicel. Be extraordinary. See Island Cotton Shop, Heineken, and Capital Financial. DBS, you know, vibes.
Mm-hmm. Texans and unwind Saturday gloves. I was never in love, never had the time, but some hurry work, laughing myself to sleep, waking up lonely. I needed someone to hold.
On the wave and on DBS TV. Hey, in studio with me is my friends from CDF. We have Jimmy Clavier here. Jimmy is responsible development and marketing senior officer. That's right, Jimmy. I got it right. Good stuff.
Right.
And we have Nosdivad Enitie here. Yes. He's events and production officer. All right. Some big titles there. Some top fellas from CDF passing through here.
Definitely.
Again, I want you to tell me a little more about the the variety we can and some of the artists we can expect to see at this this artist market that's happening from the 5th to the 7th of May.
All right, so I will go ahead and say that as indicated earlier, the artist market is basically a platform to showcase some of the most excellent pieces that have been created by our local artisans. And you will find persons who are doing work in the fine arts. You've got persons doing work in pottery, jewelry, fashion, clothing. And that is just in terms of what is being displayed for sale. But the artist market in itself is more than just what you could pick up. It has a lot more to do with the entertainment, the performances, creating an atmosphere that allows for engagement and participation by the person who is passing through. As indicated, we first started the artist market in 2013, and it was picked up by the St. Lucia Jazz and Arts Festival about 2 years ago. So this is our second year doing it. Again, it has been a collaboration between the two, the CDF and the malls. And I want to say thank you to all of the collaborators on behalf of the Cultural Development Foundation. Without their assistance, the event would not have been able to grow to the stage where it is right now, where we could have a 3-day event. And this year we have it from May 5th to May 7th. As I said, we've got the pieces, jewelry pieces, we've got fashion pieces, we've got pieces made out of bamboo, the wire pieces, that are little crafts made out of wire. We've got the pieces that are made out of glass, we've got the pieces that are made out of coconut shells. We've got a huge variety of persons coming out, a huge variety of work being displayed, and the impact that we're looking for is to see how we could penetrate other markets by putting out those pieces out for the visitors to see.
Okay.
As I indicated earlier, it's not just for the visitors, it's for the locals as well, but our main interest is to understand what will move the visitors to purchasing those pieces. What are they looking for in what is being created? Because right now the work of the Cultural Development Foundation is basically to create and to develop a cadre of persons who can provide product to the creative industries.
Right.
So once we've run the every time we run an artist market, one of the things that we do is do a survey that measures persons' appreciation of what is being displayed, what would move them to purchase a piece, how did they get information about
the actual event.
How you go about that survey?
Well, we actually would have persons mixing in with the crowds.
Okay, asking,
survey,
asking
actually,
questions.
Yeah, asking questions.
Randomly,
persons,
definitely.
Yeah. So we do that, and I mean, that type of information lends itself to the overall jazz picture. You know, in terms of how much is generated at the end of the day, how many persons visited an event, that lends itself. But for our own organization, the Cultural Development Foundation, it helps us in terms of building and creating a more solid event. As I said, the artist market is a platform to showcase our work, and we want to ensure that we are able to constantly develop and enhance that particular platform. We create platforms for our young persons to display their work, to sell their work, to ensure that they're seeing the fruits of their labor. You know, they could see the benefit from that. And our research is to basically gather that information to continue enhancing the particular platform.
Okay.
At the same time, it also helps us in determining if an artisan has a weakness in one of his products in terms of how he displays it, how he sells it, what somebody found was the downside to a particular product. We could also work with that particular artisan now to develop their own product before they actually get to the artist market. So the artist market for us serves several purposes. It's not just a matter of entertainment. It's now looking at how we could continue developing the products that our local artisans are involved in, so that they could now penetrate other markets around the place.
Good stuff, Jimmy. Now, Nos Divide, of course, he's the main guy in terms of
the production
officer. This is happening between the two malls, and you know it's free to the public.
It's definitely free.
But somebody has to pay, right? Who's financing all this thing?
Well, I feel
majority of the event is financed by
sponsors.
The main sponsors we have already elaborated on them. The St. Lucia Tourist Board is one of the main sponsors. The other two major sponsors that we have for the event are the actual malls themselves.
Yeah.
You know, it lends itself to the actual operations of the malls, and to be able to
get movement.
Yeah, because some of them, adding to what Jimmy said, because some of the persons from the JQ Mall, they deal with local stuff and they will be displaying their stuff.
This stuff as well.
Yeah, definitely.
Yes, I feel you.
Yeah,
I feel
definitely.
So it's a win-win for everyone.
Yeah, it's
for everybody.
A win-win. You know, just imagine you've created an event that is coming within a space between two malls. You've got, let's say, 1,000, 2,000 persons coming there. Right there. This is extra.
And that's the jazz atmosphere.
Business.
Of course.
Yeah. Extra business generated for both malls at the same time. So the malls are buying into it. We love them for that. And we hope that they will continue supporting us as we try to grow this event. For us, one of the greatest difficulties is actually closing that street. And just imagine you were able to close that street for three days. It's
well,
a major
create movement because they have alternatives. So it's good.
Yeah. The other element is, of course, I mean, whether or not we think of it as a monetary contribution, but to be able to get the support of the St. Lucia Police Force to allow us to close on our street to redirect traffic. All of those things have to be taken in consideration.
Yes, indeed.
We also have other partners on board with us, you know, in terms of the actual setup and design of those things. Landmark events, we have those people.
That's
on board
big people
with us.
You
know, so
that's top people there.
The musicians, all of those elements come in.
The sound,
and we have,
the lighting,
yeah.
All them components make the event what it is. And
you know,
we say thank you to all, because without them, the event wouldn't happen.
The CDF does not necessarily have a whole heap of cash. What we look for is partners who are willing to work
with us, partners with cash, collaboration,
as you said, it's a win-win situation, you know.
And
we have to take that in consideration when we're building on a platform like that.
All right, Nos Divide, I want you to encourage folks to come out on the 5th to the 7th, 3 days of, you know, artisans will be showcasing, you know, their stuff. You could purchase stuff as well. All that's happening between the two malls. Encourage the folks to come and support this.
But it's part of jazz, so I expect people to be around. And they're looking for new outfits, new gear, new style, new something, and actually something they can bring back home, especially the visitors, something they can carry on, like maybe a little gift or something. You'll get that here, made in St. Lucia. We support local and we keep it local, and that's what it is. That's what the artist market about. Keep it real, and that's where we are all about.
Yeah. I mean, in terms of the entertainment, what you could expect is the local traditional dances, masquerade,
street theater. We have street theater.
You got street theater happening. This is an area that we, as a CDF, we're bringing back the actual performance of theater performances on right there on the road. We're not talking about mob performances,
flash mob. We're talking about the real theater, kind of actual theater
on the street.
Nice. So we'll experience all that from the 5th to the 7th.
Super. And of course, towards the end of the evening, you're going to have the major performers coming on. You have the Rob's Eye Tailors, you've got the Skip Mondays and the Boings. Coming out. So of course, look out for the program, visit our website, listen to the radios to determine, you know, when and who's doing what. The information is out there. We will have it out there for you. So definitely come on down on the 5th to the 7th. If you're not there in the morning, at least you're going to be there in the evening, you know, to take any entertainment. But it's a holistic thing, and we invite everybody to come on out to participate in this.
And the CDF website, let me see if I know it, is cdfstlucia.org, right?
That's right.
No dot between the St. Lucia, word. Yeah, put no dot, you'll stick in that. cdfstlucia.org, and you could check out, you know, everything to do
check
with.
Check out our calendar, check out our updates in terms of what is happening, when it's happening. We will be, you know, doing regular updates in terms of the actual events, so check it out.
Question for you guys. Yep. So I'm a top artist. I didn't know all this was going on. I was in the hills somewhere making my things.
Hearing
all this going on now. Could I still jump on board this artist market? How can I do so?
Well, simple. You call us at the office. The number is 4579021. Ask for Nozivan. He will definitely help you register. I was just asking him a while ago whether or not we've met our quota, and he says, no, we're still at a particular number. We need to get more persons to come on board. So give us a call, 4579021, or visit our website. You could call Nozivad on his cell phone, his working number. What's your work number?
716-2174. Definitely get the information you need.
Right. So he will help you with the registration. And if you're interested in participating, as I said, we still have more opportunities, more spaces. The reason we have a set number is simply because of the size of the space.
Yeah. Right.
You got to put a stage, need to
limited space. Things have to be nice.
It has to be organized.
It has to be.
And we want people to move around so they have a better vision.
Yes.
I mean, the more we have, the better. But at the same time, we don't want it too congested. There's always another opportunity. This is something that we've been running for the last 3 years, and we hope to continue running. So if you didn't get through with us this year, definitely register us at least for next year so that you can be on board with us.
Good stuff. Right? Yeah. If the information is too much for you, you could always just walk up Bernard Hill. That's where they're located. Right? So if they answer in the phone, you find the answer in the phone quick enough, walk Bernard Hill, check them out at CDF. Yeah. Okay, it's been great chatting with you guys, man. Nostivad Enitie. And Jimmy Clavier, thank you guys so much.
You need to know a little bit about he flipped his name around.
Hey, you're not a radio boy.
All right, you gotta give me that story. That sounds interesting. That sounds like a whole show by itself, man. Good stuff, Jazz Groove.
Definitely.
Wicked. Jazz Groove.
Waiting here patiently for you to say that you sent him on his way. You sent him on his way. And I know you're worried, been tossing and turning. It's keeping you away, thinking it was a mistake. But it's time. You knew he was no good, had to let him go. You'll be fine. Just reach out your hand, now you got mine to hold. I'm telling you that, ooh, we were meant to be. Darling, can't you see that I'm your whole wide world? And he's a drop in the ocean. Ooh, wouldn't you agree? I'm the only ship that's sailing on your sea. And he's a drop in the ocean. He's a drop in the ocean. A drop in the ocean. A drop in the ocean.
Jazz Grooves on the Wave, 94.5 and 93.7 FM and the DBS TV, channel 35. Jazz Grooves again. We remind you it's the opening of jazz set for April 29th. That's at the MPP, the Mindo Philip Park. You don't want to miss this one. Movado from Jamaica, Lovin' Day from Jamaica, Old School Lovin' Day from Jamaica. Lyrical, Big Bad Boy Lyrical, got some great tunes. He will be on stage as well. Some of the best from St. Lucia will be there. We're looking at DYP will be there. Also, Afa and his Evolution Band will be there. Cedale Wildfire, Mysterio, Nerdy, Shemi J, 12 of the top reggae and soca artists will be opening this amazing festival, an unforgettable journey. It starts from 8 o'clock. That's at the Mindo Philip Park. You don't want to miss that. Get your tickets now. Steve's Barbershop, check them. They have tickets down there. Good. Jazz Grooves on the way. Of compliments, my friends at Bank of St. Lucia. All the bank you need. I'm banking my way. Digicel, Be Extraordinary, Sea Island Cotton Shop, Heineken, and Capital Financial. Vibes here. Come on. You know we good? We good, JR? We nice? Things real nice. Jazz Grooves, we say.
Jazz.